Mohammed, welcome.
Hello.
Thanks for coming on the Dubai Works podcast.
Thanks for having me, guys.
So you've got an amazing story, a very kind of creative, inspirational story. Where should we start?
Well, let me start by introducing myself, to be honest with you, because I think many listeners and viewers might not be familiar with me or my work, because I do a lot of Arabic shows.
Yeah.
And I my call to fame was an animated series called FREEJ. It was the number one viewed show in the UAE, in the history of the UAE, actually. We did 5 seasons of that. It was a groundbreaking kind of project about 4 old grandmothers. You might still see them on Fly Dubai as part of the safety video.
We see kind of animation characters in cartoons in other markets. I think of Wallace and Gromit and this type of style. And, you know, in there's Meerkat in Saudi Arabia and Tavaz and these other animators. What makes it successful? Like, how did it capture the audience?
I think back then there was a huge thirst for cultural programming, and to feature a slice of society that's very hidden from us, which is the grandmother's world. You know, you don't see anybody's grandmother. You see your own, if you're lucky to have one. But you don't see that kind of environment where they sit together. And of course, our media was not really focused on that kind of group. You'll see the random grandmother appear in a show, die 3 episodes later, part of a grand story, but not a show about them.
How you describe it there, it went from, I think it said 15 episodes, 15 minutes, to 70 episodes, and it continued and
more
continued.
More than 100 episodes.
More than 100, wow.
Yeah, more than 100. Yeah. It's like more the white hair I have in my beard is a statement.
So culturally, how was it received across the rest of the Arab world? And did they understand the Emirati grandmother, etc.?
When they started airing the show on Dubai TV, because it's it's an international TV station, so many countries can pick it up, a lot of people from Kuwait, Saudi, Oman, Bahrain, they did not understand the word. It was so local, but they were so intrigued to understand. It was so funky for them. And they picked up the dialect because of that show. So they started to understand Emirati sayings and proverbs, and because they wanted to know what they're saying. And it's like whatever she throws in, like let's say if she's saying something or a poem or something, they will be very interested in knowing. So many people told me, especially from Saudi, we picked up your accent because of FREEJ.
So there's a long story there, and many successes on the back of it, but I want to move on.
Yes.
That was animation, and that's kind of your skill set, and many kind of years perfecting that. You're now working and produce your own movie, or directing your own movie. How did that happen, and can you tell us a bit about the movie?
Man, I was approached by Imagination. Of course, Imagination is one of the most amazing companies we have. They just won an Oscar this year for Free Solo, which they produced.
Yeah.
And they actually produce a lot of, Emirati films. And I had a lot of Emirati directors who direct live action. So they came to me and they were like, listen, do you fancy directing, a movie? And I was like, I kept telling myself, I said, like, listen, you need to tick that box, live action. And because it really helps in your CV, you become a very versatile kind of director. And then I was like, yeah, well, why not? If it's with you guys, and you guys seem to know what you're doing. Just I want you to know that I'm an animation director. I don't know this stuff around me. What is this? I have no idea. I know it emits light, but I don't know how to connect it. I don't know what it takes. Yeah. It's like, don't worry about that. We'll take care of everything. And they gave me the script, which was an amazing script between... it's a body switch, which I was like, thank God it's a comedy. Between an Emirati, kind of modern Emirati young entrepreneur and his family, living in a modern... beautiful house, but not in touch with his, let's say, daughter, and this Egyptian delivery guy, who who's very gullible and loves his family, lives in Karama, and he's he has a similarly aged daughter, but the dynamics of the families are very, very different. So
it's called
Rashid and Rajab. So Rashid is the local guy, and Rajab is the Egyptian guy.
Okay. And did you learn over the course of producing it? And would you do another one? Would you direct another movie?
For the time being, no. I'm in therapy, actually. I'm in therapy land.
Yeah. And the movie's out? When's it?
So the movie's The movie is coming out in Eid, so that's almost in June 6th.
So over a month away.
Yeah, over a month away, and we will be having a premiere on the 21st of May. It's a Ramadan red carpet for us. And
so that's interesting characters and personalities in the movie.
Man, the good thing is that this film is bursting with characters that are fun, funny, and interesting. The way we've directed it, and thank God they gave me the reins to do something a little bit more. I'm a cartoony guy, so it's a more of a cartoony kind of setup of a film. Yeah. So I'm happy for that.
Do you see young people coming to you and pitching ideas? And is there a lot of talent and creativity here?
I did one show once, whereby there is this guy who studied in the States, and he is an illustrator, and I was in love with his characters. And then the project came along, whereby a show was asked. You know, I had to deliver a show. And I remember this guy, he was like 19 or 20. And the entity who wanted to create that show wanted to buy out the characters full on. Like, if I'm going to direct the show, they want to buy the rights for that character or these characters. After a while, with negotiations, this guy got paid $1 million. $1 million for sketching a character that Amazing. He loved, and he was in the States studying. But you keep an eye on them, you know, and you go like. So I asked him, "What do you was like? I bought a car. I did this." and I think that's a natural extension of, you know, you kind of identify talent.
Yeah.
And you went through a very harsh kind of journey to make it, and it's now much easier for people to make it.
I was just down at the Sketch Art Cafe. They have a new studio there.
That's my cousin's.
And it seems
we're like a talent mafia there.
But it's amazing because you can see the talent emerging from a cup, and then it more gets displayed, so you can see that kind of community growing.
Yes.
And talent being discovered.
And there's more, to be honest with you, there's more courage. People are more, you know, like courageous, and like they have the confidence and to kind of express themselves more and to have a voice. We have a lot of like art weeks and art exhibitions and film festivals and all of that, and so people like to have their own voice now with social media as well. You know, everybody's a broadcaster and everybody is a channel and everybody's a journalist too.
Yeah, so things can go viral and you can have your own brand online
as well.
Of course,
yeah.
Talking about the kind of Dubai film community and the festival and the initiatives, what do you think is needed, or what do you think is coming down the line? Are we going to see more international sets here? Is there going to be more locally produced things? And what's your kind of vision or hopes for Dubai?
Well, two things. I believe personally that the TV station setup is a dying breed, so I don't think they will last too long, because the big boys are coming, like the Netflixes and the Disneys and the Amazons and
the Stars Play and other ones
you,
as well.
You name them. Whatever startup we will have also that will be bought later by other entities.
Yeah.
They will come, and they will spend a lot of much more money on product.
Is that a good or bad thing?
That's amazing,
you?
Man. Come on, it's like I'm in heaven.
Yeah.
Because the TV model was too restrictive. For you know, you have to watch it at a certain time. They control the advertising, so they control you. So whereby the other entities are actually platforms fighting against each other to dominate a new kind of landscape. So they will come forward and they will push, and at least for the next 10 years, I think we will be in the. If you're in that side of business, you'll be in a good place. Plus, we have the expo coming up, and there's a lot of production programming work that is going on there.
Amazing.
So if you are in media for the next, I think, 3-5 years, you're in a good place.
It's a good place to be. That's a brilliant note to end it on. Thanks a lot, Mohammed, for coming in. Really appreciate it. Nice chatting to you, and good luck with the movie.
Thanks, man.
Cheers.
Thanks.
Thanks.